1 million years ago, a meteorite entered the atmosphere somewhere behind me. It exploded up in the sky. Pieces rained down all over this forest here in Sweden. And today, here on the True Vikings Metal Detecting Channel, we're gonna find out some space rocks. Let's assemble our detector and get started. This expedition will be a two-day trip because we are very remote, well above the Arctic Circle. So we're gonna pitch our tents here, stay the night, maybe two nights, and look for meteorites all over this area. We found some old tin cans down there in the hole. Someone had a good fish snack here once upon a time. But this is a great place to show you guys how the detector works. So when the coil goes over the tin can, it's gonna start shouting. Hoo-hoo! Yeehaw, my friends! That could be the meteorite. But in this case, just tin cans. Picking them up from about 1 meter now. Great machine. Let's continue and get the real stuff. The meteorites that we are looking for are called the Muonionalusta meteorites. It is a Finnish name, and for me it's easy to pronounce, but some people say it's the hardest name in the world to pronounce. Muonionalusta. The Muonionalusta is a nickel iron meteorite, so it is 100% metallic, and that will give a nice signal on our machines. Faint signal here, but very steady. Listen to what happens when I lower the coil. It's something real. It's not a ghost signal. I don't know about you guys, but I'm excited. Frodo, are you excited?
Yes, Samwise.
That's the spirit. Let's dig it. And oh yeah, it's good. Because the place to look for meteorites is in the till. And I know it's till, glacial till, because I find rocks that are sharp corners and rounded and gravel and sand. So I know it's been rotating under the ice sheets, mixing, churning everything. And that's where the meteorites are as well, after being transported for miles by the ice. So we took out another metal detector. We have lots of them here. The minelab Equinox 800, my favorite detector. And listen to this guy going bonkers. So what do we got here? Do we have 100 tiny meteorites, or do we have something else? Well, I'm gonna show you. This guy, a new metal detector. I told you we had lots of them. It just beeps everywhere. And what could it be? Well, me and Jonathan, we are geologists, so we believe it's magnetic sand, magnetic clay, iron-rich sand. And the color is also quite rusty red, which would indicate that. Just to confirm that, we whipped out our magnet. And what would you know, it collected lots of small iron minerals. We are meteorite detecting in a very hunted area, and we just stumbled upon something. Look at this, guys. This is proof that there's a lot of profit to be made in this area. We came up here and we would have hit this meteorite if it wouldn't have been cleared out maybe some 2, 3, 4 years ago. And this has been a big one. But we're too late to the party. Next one is ours. I can't tell what's wrong or right. Should I go without saying goodbye? All I know is I need to be somewhere. I would just like to remind you that for every like this video gets, we will donate 1 cent to an animal shelter. So hit that like button and help out those hungry kitties. Researchers believe that the meteorite is about 1 million years old. The age is still disputed a little bit. But a long time ago anyway, there was a big meteorite that entered the atmosphere from the northeast. And it disintegrated up in the sky and pieces rained down over a wide area. After that, there's been several ice ages. Glaciers have moved the soil, the till tumbled everything and spread out the meteorite pieces. So they cover now an area of about 25 times 15 kilometers. And they are spread somewhere out here in the forests. They can be very shallow, or they can be 10 meters down. But our detector goes to about 2-3 meters. We just uncovered more evidence that we are bang on the sweet spot of meteorite hotspot territory. Another dug out meteorite hole here. This one being much, much smaller and a bit older because there's overgrown vegetation on the till. The last hole we found over there, a couple hundred meters away, was much bigger. But here it was, and there's gotta be more. Somewhere out there. But where? Where? We noticed that when Jonathan wiggles the coil, we're getting a disturbance on our metal detector. So it looks like it's picking up the metallic buttons on his pants and maybe some metallic loops there in the shoes. So if we can't solve this issue, Jonathan will have to go without pants. Right?
What?
This meteorite strewn field, the Muonionalusta strewn field, has been known for the past 15 or 20 years, and there's been a pilgrimage of metal detecting dudes in the forest behind me. So many of the best areas are already thoroughly searched through. We have been detecting in the swamps and the forests now, in the heavily already detected area. Found lots of hole spits from old meteorites, but still looking for the juicy one. But now we're gonna switch strategy, just like Sun Tzu did back in ancient China. We're gonna go in with a flank attack and hit those logged areas. Hopefully there was a thick forest there last time detectorists were around, but now it's cleared out and we can detect every spot. The meteorites, they're gonna be somewhere out there. But I don't know how. I hope the wind will carry me and take me away to where I should be. If any of you guys are interested in meteorite hunting this area, there's a few permits you need to get. First, you need to have the permit from the landowner. In this case, it's a forestry company. They give out permits for a fee. You will also need a permission for metal detecting from the county administrative board. After you have those two permits, you're all set to go. Good luck out there, friends. Our hearts skipped a bit there for a while because we had a steady, good signal. But upon further inspection, it was just another one of those rusty tin cans laying on the ground. Probably dropped by some logging people or other metal detectorists, I don't know. So many false alarms here. I think we deserve a subscribe, or at least a like. I don't know, it's up to you guys, but we're gonna keep pushing because we know the meteorites are somewhere out here. We have the most amazing signal ever! And this is how a meteorite is supposed to sound like, ladies and gentlemen. I can't wait to get digging. Meteorite right here. I'm gonna go in with the Equinox first and then the shovel. And then we're gonna carry the big meteorite home. Let's see what we have here. Oh man. Steady 16. And the smallest metal detector. Oh, it's shallow. It's shallow. That's not a good sign. It's big, deep, or surface. Oh, I see something. And it's tin can. We found a tin can. 2 days of hunting and no meteorites, but we'll get them next time. If you like this kind of content, press the subscribe and like, and I'll see you again in next week's video. True Vikings, over and out.